What's up, guys? It's Chris, and welcome back to My Corvette Life. Today, we are doing the shocks on the C4 Corvette, so let's go ahead and get started. So we're going to start up at the front here, and the first thing that we need to do is remove this little access panel right above the shock tower. So first thing is we're just going to go ahead and pull the weather stripping off here, set that to the side, and then we need a 10 millimeter to take off these 5 volts. So next we're gonna take this top bolt off. Before I do that, I just wanna go ahead and take note of what that top rubber piece looks like. You can see how it's bulging out way past this metal washer. To me, that looks like it was over tightened. It should be even with the outside edge of that metal washer. So it looks like it was squished super tight and it's bulging out. You can see the rubber is kind of ripping at the seams there, so not really sure how old this is, but we're gonna get it all corrected. And let me find out what size this is. So for the top right here, you're going to need a 5 millimeter Allen, and then this you're going to need a 17 millimeter. Okay, now if you have a ratcheting 17 millimeter like this, that's even better. So go ahead and slip that over, make sure you're going in the right direction. Get your 5 millimeter Allen in the top there, hold it in place. Now let's go ahead and turn it. There we go. All right, so now that we've got the top off, we're gonna go ahead and remove the bottom 2 bolts. You can see them right there. Now there is a nut on the bottom side of the A-arm, so you're gonna need a deep 13 millimeter socket for that and a 13 millimeter wrench for the top. Okay, now with both bolts removed, let's reach in and pull it right out. Okay, so here we've got the new shock. Now I will tell you guys that this particular car did not come with the Z51 suspension. Now, even the non Z51 suspension cars still came with Bilstein shocks, but they are a different shock. If you look up the part numbers, they are different between Z51 and the base suspension, but they are both Bilstein. So just be aware of that when you're ordering your parts, get the right ones. Also, just FYI, the 2 bolts that go in the bottom here, you will be reusing them with the new shocks. The new shocks do not come with those bolts. However, it does come with new hardware for the top. So now we're ready to put the new shock back in. So we're gonna go ahead and slip the new one back in, and then we're going to use our floor jack and kind of preload the suspension just so it's kind of, you know, at its normal ride height so we can torque it properly down, and then we should be good to go. Okay, so we are fully installed now, and just for reference, that is what the upper rubber bushing should look like. All right, so now we're gonna move on to the back. Now we're gonna go ahead and support this with a floor jack. So on the top here, we got 2 13 millimeter bolts. And then on the bottom, we have an 18 and a 21. So, simple enough, remove the bolts and that shock will come right out.
Okay, so now once you get that shock out of the car, you're gonna need to do a couple of things. First thing is take this piece out of the bottom here. You're gonna need to take the other nut off the other side, and then it just slips right out the hole. And then we gotta take this bracket off of the top here. So in order to do that, we need to take this nut off, slip the bushing off, and then slip this off. So same process that we did on the front shocks. We're gonna use that 5mm Allen in the top here, and I believe that is a 17mm nut, and then we'll go ahead and spin it off. Okay, so now we're ready to assemble the top of the new shock. So the new shocks do come with all new washers and bushings. So you're gonna go ahead and take the larger of the two washers, put that on the bottom. The larger of the two bushings, put that on top of that. And then take your bracket right here, put it right there. And then the top bushing has this little deal on the bottom here that fits right into the hole through the top of this bracket. And then the top washer goes on just like that. And then you got your nut. And then we're gonna go ahead and tighten that down to spec. All right, so we've got the new shock reassembled, ready to put back in the car. So let's go ahead and reinstall. Alright, we are fully installed. Now these top two bolts get torqued down to 22 foot-pounds, and then these two down here get torqued down to 66 foot-pounds. Alright, both sides are done. You know, I could just sit back and stare at this car all day long. I cannot believe how big of a transformation this car has had in, you know, just a short bit of time that I've owned it since last December. So it's been 7-ish months now, and it is like a totally different car. It's awesome. I mean, just look how clean this is. Like, I could sit and look at this all day long. Ooh, buddy. Good stuff. So, project is complete. I will list all of the torque specs in the video description below. I'll also list the part numbers for the different shocks for Z51 and non-Z51, just so you guys know. So go ahead and take a look at that. So that is going to do it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please smash that thumbs up button. If you're not already subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button below. Until next time, we'll see you guys later. Take care.